As you can see, I created a problem for myself to having less space for the final TX amplifier. The output of this filter after the band filter and the diode switch is less than 0.1 milliwatt, so that's not much. So I added a very small MMIC here. It's the NGA486, and the output is 1.4 milliwatt. It's less than expected, only 12 dB gain. But as you can see, I did another approach. I did not make this amplifier on a separate board and edit that board, but I soldered it directly to the main board. That was not a very good idea, because now it is not very easy to replace for a better functioning amplifier. And also, you can see I had problems with my connector. If you look at the back of this transceiver, you see there's a connector for the antenna, there's the heatsink, and less space for the voltage and eventual other connections. So that all had to, I had it all to do here. So yeah, I ran into trouble here. So this 1.4 milliwatt from this NGA MMIC went to a transistor. I tried several ones, 2N4427, 2N3866, BFW16A, but I ended up with a VHF-UHF transistor, BFR96, and I have now 230 milliwatt output here. So I thought that's a nice power to drive an RD16HHF1 transistor. So I ordered one, actually two, and they turned out to be fake. So thank you, AliExpress. A friend of me had a 2SC1307, and with this schematic I brought the output to about 3 watts. And as you can see, it is a straightforward circuit. The collector voltage is all the time on the plus, and I switch TX on and off with this bias current that lifts the base of the transistor about 0.7 volts. And then we have some tuning and a two low pass filters behind it. And this is maybe a bit strange circuit. It has nothing to do with HF, but I put also some voltage on this antenna connector to switch a power amplifier at the end. So it has nothing to do with this transceiver. For this, instead of this circuit, you can also take another MMIC, of course. They can be ordered completely built PCBs, and for this one you can also buy a complete power amplifier of a few watts. But we like to build it ourselves, so I build it this way. As you can see, all coils are air wound. They are round 5 millimeter or 6 millimeter, and the number of turns is 6 or 5. It depended on what I already had as a coil or what I had as a wire. Let's hook it up to the spectrum analyzer. I connected this transceiver to a lot of attenuation, 40 dB, to protect the spectrum analyzer. Adjustments here are from 10 MHz to 160 MHz. So you can see the wanted carrier, the second harmonic and the third harmonic. When I switch the transmitter on, you see we have already a lot of noise. This is about a half a meter of the distance of the microphone because of the compressor in it. So you have a high audio level. This is when I talk nearby the microphone. If I remove the connector of the microphone, you see that it is reduced a lot. It's not very stable, but it is this is the carrier suppression. I add the microphone connector again, and you can see the second harmonic. It's about 45 dB low, and the third harmonic you cannot even notice. So that's with the spectrum analyzer. After connecting the setup to the HP milliwatt meter, you can see the output is 0.3 milliwatt full scale. And I do have 40 dB attenuation, so it means it's about 3 watts output. This is PA3CRX Papa Alpha 3 Charlie Romeo X-ray, and as you can see it has a lot of high average power. If this power is enough is of course depending on what kind of experiments you do. The heatsink doesn't warm up too much, but it is only 3 watts, and if you want to have more power with about the same configuration, likely this filter has a lot of attenuation because it is very narrow. Maybe it could be made some wider with less gain, and then you have of course more output power. With some antennas I experimented, and only with the 200 milliwatt out of this BFR transistor I worked already many countries and more than 100 contacts. But I also made an amplifier for this one, and I will make an additional video about that. So for now this is it, and looking forward to your comments and experiments.